Hi friends, if you like my videos, subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. So in this video, I'm going to explain to you about animal cloning and also the formation of Dolly sheep by using this animal cloning technique. So to know about this animal cloning, firstly you have to know what is meant by this cloning. Cloning is a process of producing genetically identical individuals of an organism either naturally or artificially is called as cloning. So here, the genetically identical individuals will be produced. From where it will be produced? From its mother individual. So that genetically identical individual will be similar to that of mother individual. So that is the main aim of this animal cloning. So by using this animal cloning technique, the formation of Dolly sheep has been taken place. So now, here, the scientist called as Sir Ian Wilmot is a scientist who discovered this Dolly sheep, who produced this Dolly sheep by using a technique called as animal cloning. So he was born on 7th July 1944 and the main discovery which has been done by the scientist is a Dolly sheep by using animal cloning technique. So the method which has been used by the scientist for the production of Dolly sheep in this animal cloning technique is somatic cell nuclear transfer. So how this procedure has been performed by the Sir Ian Wilmot? So how this Dolly sheep has been formed by using this animal cloning technique? So total procedure will be explained now detailedly. So now let us discuss about Dolly the sheep. It was born on 5th July 1996 in United Kingdom. So what is the experiment which has been performed by Sir Ian Wilmot for the production of the Dolly sheep? Let us see now. So the first step which has been performed by that particular scientist is taking two sheep under the consideration. So the first sheep name is Finn Dorset sheep, and come into the name of the second sheep, Scottish Blackface Eve is the name of the second sheep. So these are the two sheep which has been taken under the consideration for the formation of the Dolly sheep, right? So what is the major difference between this first and second sheep is the second sheep face will be totally black in color. But here in the first sheep, the face will be normal white in color. So this is a major difference between the first sheep and second sheep. So this point is very much important to remember. So now this will be your first step. So now coming to the second step, what you are going to do is that from the first sheep, you are going to extract the mammary cell from the mammary gland. And now on the other hand, from the second sheep, you are going to extract the egg cell. Right? So this will be your second step. And now coming to your third step, what you are going to do is that you are going to extract the nucleus from this mammary cell. And on the other hand, from this second sheep, egg cell has been extracted, right? And from that egg cell, the nucleus will be removed and only the empty cell will be taken under the consideration. So here the nucleus has been extracted and it will be taken under the consideration. But here only the empty cell will be taken under the consideration, where the egg cell or is the nucleus from the egg cell will be removed. So this will be your third step. So now this nucleus and empty egg cell will undergo fusion and forms a fused cell. So here fusion technique will be performed by micro injection, and that micro injection technique is used where this nucleus can enter into this egg cell and it will be injected into this egg cell, and finally it forms a fused cell. Fused cell means here the normal empty egg cell will consist of the nucleus because it has been fused, right? And now this fused cell will be cultured under the petri plate by taking a petri plate. So now here you are going to take a petri plate, and in this petri plate you are going to place this fused cell, and particular nutrients will be supplied for it in such a way that fused cell will get developed and forms an embryo in the petri plate itself, right? Because we are going to culture it in a petri plate, so that egg cell will get divided properly and will get developed into this embryo. And now this embryo will be implanted into a second sheep. Not first sheep, second sheep. So the name of the second sheep which we have given is the Scottish Blackface Eve, right? So this embryo will be implanted into the second sheep. And now, after few days, the sheep will give birth to a Dolly. So in this way, the Dolly will be produced. And the Dolly B is produced from the second sheep. Then the name of the second sheep is Scottish Blackface Eve, right? So in this way, the Dolly is produced. So now you have to remember some of the major points of this Dolly sheep. So what are they? So here the Dolly will express the characteristics of sheep 1, that is Finn Dorset sheep, even though it was born from the sheep 2. So that the Dolly has been produced from the second mother, right? So it exhibits the characteristics of this first sheep. So white exhibits the characteristics of this first shape because the nucleus which has been extracted is from the first shape but not from the second shape, right? So we know that the nucleus consists of chromosomes, and the chromosomes will make the particular organism to exhibit its characteristics, right? So that's only the reason the Dolly will express the characteristics of a sheep one, that is Finn Dorset sheep, even though it was born from the sheep too. So if you see the diagram of the Dolly which has been drawn here, so what is the diagram which has been drawn here of the Dolly, where the face which has been seen in this Dolly will not be shaded, which means that the face of this Dolly is not black in color. So if you remember the first point which I have said you, the second sheep, the name of the second sheep which I have given is a Scottish Black Whale Eve. So if you see here, the second sheep is totally, the face of the second sheep is black in color, but the face of this first sheep is white in color. So the Dolly face is also white in color, which means that the Dolly will express the characteristics of the sheep one, right? Even though it was born from the sheep two, because the nucleus has been extracted from the sheep one, where the nucleus consists of the chromosomes, and that chromosomes will make the particular organism to exhibit the characteristics, right? So the reproduction, the type of reproduction which has been done for the production of this Dolly is asexual reproduction. Why the asexual reproduction? Because the characteristics has been obtained from a single cell, that's nothing but the sheep one, from the sheep one, right? And Dolly gave birth to 6 offsprings, and the name of those offsprings are Bonnie. And in the first delivery, Bonnie has came out, and coming to the second delivery, twins has been came out, and the name of those twins are Sally and Rosie. And coming to the third delivery, triplets has been came out, and the name of those triplets are Lucy, Darcy and Cotton. So these are the offsprings which has been delivered by this Dolly. So the Dolly was died on 14th February 2003 by lung cancer, and the name of that lung cancer is ovine pulmonary adenocarcinoma, and this is a lung cancer which is mainly caused by retrovirus JSRV, and the lifespan of this Dolly is 6.5 years. So this is the method where the Dolly was produced by a scientist called as Sir Ian Wilmot by performing animal cloning technique. So hope you would like this video, and if you like my explanation, just do like and subscribe, and the notes of this topic will be given in the WhatsApp group, and the invite link of that WhatsApp group will be given in the description box. So by using that link, you can join us in the WhatsApp group, and the notes will be provided over there. And if you like my explanation, just do like and subscribe, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, you can comment in the comment box. Thank you.